Welcome to the show. It's Tuesday, January 17th. In fact, it's Fat Tuesday.
It's February.
Oh, it's February. Listen, I don't even know what day it is. Well, Fat Tuesday.
What's in that cup?
What happens on Fat Tuesday? Who's home eating punchkies?
I'm not. I'm here being serious and dieting.
Yeah, well.
I ate some lettuce before I came.
Like I said earlier, I would rather have a jelly donut, but, you know. Have at it. If that's your thing,
that's good.
Keep eating those punchkies.
Well, they made a lot of them, so you got to eat them up.
Yeah, you got to support the local bakeries.
Be baked for nothing.
Right. I wonder what other cities in the U.S. celebrate Fat Tuesday like with punchkies.
You know, in New Orleans, do they eat punchkies?
Here's another fact that we have no idea. Could we have an expert please tell us? No.
You know what? We will come back with you next week on that. We'll look up.
Okay, so on our last show, we closed with Paula telling us about one of my favorite stories. She plays music and sings to little kids in preschool. And I'm jealous because it sounds like a lot of fun. So tell us again what it is you do.
Okay, so I go to this preschool and I do two concerts, and it's very intimate and the kids are on the ground and everything. So last week I did their Valentine's party, and there were girls dressed in Barbie gowns and all red sparkle gowns, and the boys had little bow ties. It was like formal.
Wait, how old are they?
They're like 3 and to 5. So there's a little group and they don't hardly talk. You know, they just kind of, I wore this today, or my mom, you know, they like to tell you things. And
they're just putting together sentences.
Oh, they have to say stuff. But anyway, we were rocking and rolling and having a great time, and we were doing SpongeBob. Every week we got to do SpongeBob. And this kid, so it's cold and flu season, coughed, and a piece of spit went right in my eye.
Oh, my God.
And I'm in the middle of a song, and I'm like, that just landed on my eyeball.
And because you're such a professional, you just continue.
I kept going, and I just blinked a whole bunch. I hope I don't get sick.
Do you try and blink it out of your eye?
I had my hands on the guitar. I couldn't even.
You're like, oh, yeah. So, measles, mumps, Ebola, what?
It's a fun gig, and I it's probably one of my favorite gigs every other week that I do this show. So
yeah, she's always in a really good mood after doing that, and it sounds like a lot of fun. Well, what else did you do over the weekend?
Oh, gosh, over the weekend, I did the usual things. You know, I went to that
No,
place.
What else did you do?
My mother-in-law was in town.
Okay.
And I just got my kitchen redone, so I'm looking for a cookie jar, a colorful cookie jar. Mm. So we went to the Royal Oak Farmers Market on Sunday. They have their antique show, and I couldn't find a cookie jar. So I went home and I went on Amazon, and because I have a gift card I want to use, and I found a gnome cookie jar. And I know gnomes, are they like out of
I don't know. Is it?
I like it. I'm hanging with my gnomies. I like the gnome.
So does it colorful or is it?
It's
just
very colorful, and it's the gnome, and he's got a cookie in one hand, and he's got a cup of coffee or milk, and it's and my husband's like, do not get that, and I got it today.
It's gonna, today.
Oh, well, I ordered it, and it's going to be coming. So well. I'm excited. He goes, I like the way it looks, really clean, and the, you know, and nothing on the counters, and I'm like.
Well,
gotta have a cookie jar.
You need to stuff it with his favorite cookies, so he'll like it.
I will.
He can't hate it.
Exactly. And now I'm looking for a really colorful butter dish.
You know what? Butter dishes are usually not very colorful.
I found a bunch on eBay, Amazon, like a Fiesta one.
That's what I was trying to think of what that was called.
Those are $40.
Wow, don't break it.
I know, it will break in shipping.
Why don't you make your own butter dish?
Oh, gee.
Go to that place.
Creative Art Studio.
Yeah, Creative Art Studio.
That is a great idea. I'm going to call them when I get home. Can I see that pen?
Huh.
I'm going to.
Note to self.
Note to self. I have to write things down.
Well, what else is on your list of stuff to talk about?
Well, a couple things that are very interesting. Lady Gaga is getting married.
Whoa!
I like her. I would love to go to that wedding. Could you imagine?
No, honestly, I have no idea. I don't know a whole lot about Lady Gaga, although you did meet her.
I met her when I played at a Lollapalooza, and my kids were with me, and they go, that's Lady Gaga over there. And I go, oh, no, it's not. And I'm like, oh, my gosh, it is. And she just had, like, a top on and a little G-string, and we went over and met her, and she hugged
the
kids.
Oh, you're like, hey, kids.
Like, she doesn't have any pants on. But she was so nice. She was very nice.
She was, what, 18 then? That was a long time ago.
No, it was, like, 4 years ago.
I don't know.
I was 18.
Okay, so congratulations, Lady Gaga. I wonder if you'll be invited.
I would like to go.
Will she dress like a piece of bacon?
She would probably.
Oh, will she wear her meat dress?
It'll be white meat. It'll be pork. Maybe she's a virgin.
Oh, yeah. I'm sure she is.
Yeah. So I wanted to start something new this week.
Okay.
And I get the idea from, like, David Letterman and that kind of thing. You know, the pros that we look up to and have a top 10.
We aspire to be like.
I want to do a top 10 every week.
All right. Well, did you write this yourself or did your neighbors help you?
No, my neighbors did not help me. But I did go out to some of our Chatty Patty Paula Walla Talk Show fans.
Okay. Let's hear it.
Also known as Facebook.
Yeah.
And I, okay.
We are on Facebook. And there's a lot of Chatty Patties on Facebook, but there's no Chatty Patty Paula Walla. We're right. The only ones.
And you should visit our page and make comments.
Yeah. Tell us how bad we are.
Tell us what you like and don't like about the show.
Tell us just what you like, the good things only.
And what you want to see.
Okay. Well, what are the top 10? Did people suggested these ideas?
Yes.
Okay.
And I got way more than 10, okay. So I condensed it down, and some people did say the same thing. So I said, what are your top 10 reasons to stay in Michigan in the winter?
Oh.
Many people said snow days, and most of the people that said that were not kids. Like, what, do you get off work or something?
Yeah, that's kind of a new trend, is it? Sometimes, well, it didn't ever used to be that way, but now sometimes they say everybody stay home, don't come into work.
Well, did you ever go, like, grocery shopping the day before a snowmageddon?
Yes.
And it's like everybody's
horrible.
In a mad rush. And
the bread's all gone.
There's no bottled water suddenly. And like, oh, my gosh, I didn't know I needed bottled water. Anyway, so many people said snow days. Few people said great snuggling weather. Really? I can snuggle in Florida.
Yeah, I don't know. Maggie?
People can work from home.
What?
People can work from home.
Oh, well,
Maggie
you're right.
Works from home.
See, it didn't used to be. People didn't used to work at home, but now people can because of the internet. Back in the days before the internet, there was no working at home.
Well, you know, if we ever have a really bad snow day and it's one of our days to film, we should do it at home. We'll do it on Skype. Okay, a couple of people said they stay in Michigan in the winter, and this is really funny, because of the change of seasons.
I get it.
I get it, too.
I get it, too. But every spring, that's when I get sick. I can stay healthy all winter long. It's when it must be the mold.
The mold's coming out of the ground.
Yeah, I don't know. I always get sick in the spring, so. But I do like the season changes. Fall's
I do, too,
my favorite.
But I think winter's a little long.
Yeah, winter's a little long.
This person, my neighbor Daryl, said this twice. Michigan is shark-free. Hello.
Whew. Whew. Don't have to worry about
whatever. Many people said snow is pretty.
Snow is pretty.
It is pretty. But when it gets black, like on Woodward, and it's like, all right, melt and bring me some new stuff.
Yeah.
Someone said it's a cheap place to live. It's cheap to live in Michigan.
So it is pretty cheap.
Anita says, well, too much ice on the wings may make your plane crash, so it's best to just
stay on the ground. Stay on the ground. I don't know. Listen, when I flew back from Phoenix recently, well, Vegas, we were making record time getting back to Detroit. And
that tailwind.
Everyone was in a great mood. It was the best flight, and we're over Detroit, and they announce the landing conditions aren't that great. We might have to land at another airport.
Where are you going to go to?
Yeah, Kalamazoo? Where are we going to go? I know, like, please.
Catch a cab?
I'm thinking, please take us to Chicago where we have to be stuck there, right?
We have people there.
Don't drop me off in Flint where someone's got to come pick me up and then drive me to the Detroit Wayne. You know, I mean, that would have been pretty complicated. But it turned out that we did land, and I was amazed at what a great job the pilot did. But there was a lot of snow and ice on the ground. Like, we landed on lots of snow.
That scares the crap out of me.
I know. They're like, it's not safe to land. And then they're like, okay, now it is. I'm like, are you sure?
The little guys out there shoveling.
Sure?
Little
yeah.
gnomes with the cookie jar head.
Okay.
Okay,
another
so.
Reason to stay in Michigan.
Great snowmobile trails.
Yes.
If you have a snowmobile.
Yeah, so
like,
I grew
up... am I going to go walking?
Yeah, I grew up in Lake Orion, where living is a vacation. Clearly, that is their motto. And we didn't have a snowmobile, but all my friends did. So I grew up snowmobiling. And when I got married and moved to Royal Oak... So it was 1990, and we got a lot of snow back then. And I said to my husband, we should get a snowmobile. And he's like, why? Because I'm like, when there's lots of snow, we could drive to the grocery store. He's like, no, you can't do that in Royal Oak.
Yeah, you can't.
There are no snowmobiles.
You just go on the street.
No, you would get a ticket, I think.
If they catch you. If they catch you.
I've never seen a snowmobile go down the street in Royal Oak.
I'm gonna find out for next week's show. Ticket.
When I was a kid growing up.
Maggie's talking.
Yes. When I was a kid growing up on Normandy Road, the other side of Woodward, which is still Royal Oak, we had a snowmobile and my dad would drive around the house in a circle.
Well, that's fun.
With a dog sled, and all the kids would run out.
I was thinking for emergency purposes.
No.
Like if I had to...
You could create a path for the neighbors to walk on.
I don't know. Snowmobiles are a lot of fun. But
hook a plow up to that bad boy. You'll make some friends.
Yeah, I know. Okay, so what else?
It's home, some people said.
It's where my family is. I don't want to leave my family.
I heard that.
That's the number one thing for me.
And then the number one thing, there's foaling and feather bowling, and that's only in Michigan.
Right. I know. Foaling is so awesome. What's foaling.com?
Yes, don't do foaling.
In fact, my husband went foaling this weekend. He's trying to get me to go all the time, and I'm like, you need to take men, okay? I like it, but I'm not really, it's not going to be fun with me. Take some dudes.
He should call my husband because he would do
it. Yeah. Well, I think he's going to try and go on Sundays regularly or something.
Oh. Mm-hmm. He can do that while I'm at the wine bar.
Right. Yeah, send your husband so he's not... causing trouble at the wine bar.
Yes.
So you can drink wine in peace.
Absolutely.
All right.
So what'd you do over the weekend?
Well, first of all, I want to talk about the, once again, Paul and I are optimists. We're planning this big fundraiser called the Bowlibration. It's going to be on March 15th at 1:30. So I sent out 300 letters.
Oh my God. Do you know how many paper cuts? I thought of you for 3 days.
Paula was nice enough to help me stuff 300 envelopes on before an Optimist meeting.
At 7 a.m.
At 7 a.m. And I went and got 300 stamps and went home and put stamps on all those letters by myself. But I already got a call. Leon and Lulu's is going to make a donation.
Excellent.
And it's something I have to pick up. So I want to, you know, is it a couch?
Is it a colorful butter dish?
Oh, I don't know. Hopefully.
I will bid on that. Depending
Hopefully.
On the color. Because I did see one there. It was yellow with white polka dots, and it was kind of cute.
Oh.
And I think it would look good by the gnome.
Or wait for the clay and glass show. They'll have colorful butter dishes. One of a kind. Don't you want a one of a kind butter dish?
I want to call Creative Art Studio.
Oh, make your own.
Yep. All the kids do it. You know, it'll be all like messy kid art.
Yeah. Have your dog do it. Paint it. Lucy, put a paintbrush in her mouth.
Speaking of the dog, I just got to say this really quick. We have like this brand new leather couch that she is not in any way, shape, or form allowed on. And to this morning, I get up, and last night before I went to bed, I had a blanket on, and I just threw it on the couch. And I get up this morning, and I walk out, and she's laying on it on the couch that she's so not supposed to be on. And she just looks at me. She puts her head down really low, and then she just laid back down.
It's cold on a leather couch. What's the big deal?
The dog has a bed. Oh, no, she was on a blanket. She has a bed with a blanket in front of a fireplace. Go lay there.
Oh.
So that was just kind of funny.
She's showing you that she's human.
Yes.
And she deserved to sit on the couch.
But when I looked at her and she just pretended like I didn't see her and it was adorable and I let her stay.
I keep talking about my son and his fiance, their dog. They've been living with us. And this dog is not even a year old and he's huge. And it's so funny. Like we can hear one of them holding the dog down when the other one comes home from work and can see, you know, the dog can see them coming home and he gets so excited and it's just so sweet because by his, you know, his little puppy groans, you can tell exactly what he's feeling. Like he doesn't, you know, it's like excitement, sadness, you know, he'll be like, oh, and they'll make him, they won't feed him till after we eat dinner. So he like has to sit there and watch us eat dinner and the whole time he's just like, oh my God, I'm so hungry. Like you can just tell it's just the saddest noise ever.
You should have join? Does he beg?
He's so sweet. No, he's just a baby, and he can't control his noises, and he's just like, oh, crying to himself all the time, and it's just so cute to listen to.
I love that. He is very cute.
He is cute. Like when you see a little baby like crying or having a tantrum and the mom's like sweating it out and you're like, oh, that's so cute. Because, you know, I can sleep to a baby crying. It's just something you have to get used to.
I can't. But I want to ask you while I'm thinking of it, is Finn going to be in the wedding?
No.
Wouldn't that be fun?
No. This dog is crazy.
Yeah, but that's another year away. He can go to training school.
He's been to training school.
We took Lucy to training school, and the guy that was training, he was really great, and all the dogs did really great, and he looked at us at the end of the class, and he said, your dog has no use for you.
That's so
weird. And I'm like,
what
is that supposed to mean? Our dog has no use for us. I felt really...
That's rude.
It was sad.
It was unconditional love that your dog feels
like, trust
for
me,
you.
That dog has use for us.
Yeah.
Eating.
Yeah.
And that's it.
Belly scratching.
She didn't really do that.
No?
No. She doesn't really play.
That's the only way I can control this big dog is to stand over it and like hold its collar and scratch its neck.
Oh God, hold you down.
Yeah.
We should take him to Scrubbers. Scrubbers is a self-serve dog wash. Have you ever heard of it?
No, but we need to go to Scrubbers.
I want to go with you.
Okay.
I'll video. The dog has like these steps. Maggie's gone with me with Lucy. Steps, and then you have a chain, and then you chain them there so they can't move.
Oh, right.
And they give you these aprons, and they give you the shampoo and the towels and the special no-tear shampoo for the eyes. Like, I'm going to wash my dog's eye area. And ear cleaner, and then you all scrub them, and they got all these brushes, and then they shake, and everybody gets wet, and there's four bays. So water's just flying, and dogs, and it's just super fun.
Yeah, because I want him to spend more time outside, but everyone's like, no, he'll be stinky from the snow. You know, you get wet. The dog gets wet.
Right. Just spray some Febreze on him.
Well.
But let me know when you go to Scrubbers, because I'll meet you up there. I'll take photos or something.
Maybe we'll wait till the weather's warmer.
Yeah. Well, he's going to get muddy. You know, you haven't dealt
with he got shaved.
Okay.
They took the dog to the groomer, and he got shaved.
Muddy Paws is going to come through your house in the spring.
Oh, in the spring. Yeah.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun. Well, we used to wipe our dog's paws when she would come in, and she hates that. Like, you have a little towel, and that's irritating.
I mean, this dog's paws are, like, this big.
Yeah. You need a couple towels.
You're right. I do. My lawn is muddy. It's not that.
Yep.
It's going to be flooded.
How are you going to keep them in the yard? You going to get electric fence?
Okay.
I don't know, right?
Yeah. I'm not sure I want to talk about this on TV.
Oh,
because
okay.
Is it a law that you have to have a fenced-in area if you have a dog?
I'm going to write this down and look into it.
I think it is.
Fence. Yeah, I think it is, too.
So I want to make a tiny fenced-in area and then not make him stay there all the time, but say, like, that's the dog area.
Like a kennel. You know what my friends did one time? They had a dog that was out of control, and they wanted to have a nice garden, like a vegetable garden. So they built a dog kennel, and they put the garden in the kennel. And the dog ran around the yard, but it was so...
It pooped on all their produce?
No, that was the produce was in the kennel. So the dog couldn't get to
it. Oh, that's brilliant. Hilarious. Yeah. I thought you meant they put the dog and the garden in the kennel.
They would unlock it and go in there and water and pick and
prune.
That
would keep out deer and, I mean, well, not that we have deer, but...
They lived in Warren. I mean, it wasn't, but...
There's deer in Warren.
Yeah. Not in this neighborhood. There wasn't deer. But isn't that weird?
Yeah, I like it. Why not?
I thought it was really weird. It looked
You
really
do what you got to do, right?
It looked bad.
I miss having a vegetable garden. I used to always have... a really good one. And then our house now, the dirt isn't really that great.
You need raised beds.
So I know, but I don't know. I kind of gave up, but I would like to work on that for the summer.
You know, I would like to do that too, actually, because I only have certain spots and I like growing vegetables.
We had the biggest strawberry patch at our old house behind my garage, and it ended up, by the time we sold the house, it went from the garage to the back fence. Like, it just took over, and we couldn't even, you know, it was just so many great strawberries. I miss that.
You should go and ask him if you can pick some.
I know. Hey, I planted these. I want to go back there and be like, can I have this hosta?
You know,
I need some of these perennials.
We had had a party over the holidays, and this guy drove by really slow, and my husband was outside, and he goes, I grew up in this house. Can I come in? Or, you know, or he didn't ask if he could come in, but he just said he grew up there. My husband said, well, do you want to come in? And we were having a big party. And he came in.
And so he's like, okay.
We offered him a beer. He didn't want a beer or anything. But he's like, this is so cool. I grew up in this house, and it's so different. I mean, we remodeled the whole house. But in the basement, there was this bar on the beams, and my husband always wondered what that was. And he goes, I put that in there. It was my chin-up bar. But I'm thinking, it's way up. When you hit your head, it was literally this far from the ceiling.
Did he want to, like, find the secret spot where he hid some money? And
no, because we ripped it all apart. We remodeled. But what was neat was we had some extra plans from the house when the house was built, and it was like the architect was on there, and then the owner signed it, and it was his dad's signature.
Oh, that's
so
cool.
So my husband gave him an extra
set.
Oh,
that was really nice.
He was just like, oh, my gosh, this is so amazing.
Have you ever gone, does your mom still live in
my
the house you grew up in?
Yes.
Wow, she's lived in the same house since she got married.
No, but they moved there before I was born.
Okay.
So she still lives there, and on my bedroom, it still says Paula's room.
Aw. What about everybody else? Is it the same, or did she turn a bedroom into a sewing room or anything?
Nope. Actually, the sewing room at one point was like a pass-through room. That was my bedroom when I was really little because we had 5 kids. But, yep, she still lives in that house.
Wow.
She still has a rotary phone in the basement that she uses.
Did you get all your stuff out of there?
Yes.
She made everybody take their stuff.
But my other siblings didn't get all of it. Most of it.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I keep having these garage sales, and I'm like, Mom, what can we sell? And we're slowly emptying that house out. I've sold everything at Knickknacky.
Yeah, stuff. You got to do a little bit at a time, because when a senior citizen, a family member that's a senior is moving out, and all of a sudden you got to get rid of all that stuff. I've been to estate sales where I didn't even know the people, and I cry because I'm like, this is every little thing they've ever had their entire lives. Like, you kind of have to slowly start getting rid of stuff.
Yeah. Some of those estate sales, it's like they sell people's bras and stuff, and I think it's really bizarre.
Like, really? Well, remember the rummage sale at your church, and I went to help, and I was in charge of the panty section. I'm like, what?
It was the lingerie section.
The lingeries. I had to fold used lingerie. Anything for you know, public service.
Yes. Anything for a quarter. Well, yeah. That's coming up, too, that rummage sale, if you'd like to help again.
Okay. I did get a nice little tablecloth out of it.
Yes. We could get props for the show.
Oh, you know what? I think I'm going to freaking buy a sewing machine. Here's the deal. Is my mother-in-law years ago gave me her old sewing machine. And this is so long ago that Haberman's Fabrics was on Center Street in Center and 4th Street in Royal Oak. And I used to carry this sewing machine to my sewing class, and it was at least 80 pounds more than everybody else's sewing machine because it was so old. So I seriously broke my back doing this. So anyway, my husband was like, no, we're not getting a new sewing machine. I'm like, they're pretty cheap now. I mean, they're the price, you know, they used to be more. So I never got one, and I think I want to... Last time I borrowed someone's sewing machine, I made tablecloths. So I'm buying myself a sewing machine. Darn it, I want to sew again.
And then we can have a tablecloth.
I'm going to make us a kidney-shaped tablecloth.
Because this is
this
a very
is a weird
table.
This table is very odd.
I don't sew, and I don't like needles, and I don't sew. I wish I could. Maybe I should try. Maybe I should.
Well, I also went to the Royal Oak Education Foundation fundraiser this weekend. It's like our third year in a row. My husband and I have gone, and it's my favorite fundraiser because it's at Mirepoix at Holiday Market. And it's like the ultimate kitchen party.
Yes.
You know, you go to a party and everyone hangs out in the kitchen. This is like the biggest kitchen ever.
Yes.
And the food was really great, and it was not a sold-out crowd, but I'm not going to name names, but you know if you'd gone in the past and didn't show up this year, so next year maybe we'll see you there. But
I didn't go this year. Sorry, I had company from out of town. Are you talking to me? I'm talking to you.
And
well, I had company. My mother-in-law was in town for
I met Lisa
days.
Bradford.
Oh,
that's the first time I was literally introduced to her, and I'm like, Paula's been...
Oh, you met her. I thought you said you meant her. I'm like,
no.
You're naming names.
No, no. Lisa was there. She was a good girl.
Yes.
And she's actually going to be here in about 5 minutes. I didn't tell you that. I have a meeting when we finish here, and Lisa's going to be here.
We should get her in here.
Yeah, I know. What?
Who is that?
Lisa Bradford, she's a realtor that lives in your neighborhood, right?
She used to. I'm not sure if she still lives over that way.
I don't know. Paula used to always be like, you know Lisa. I'm just going to say her name 1,000 times, poor lady. But I'd always be like, no, no, no. And I was just introduced to her.
Did you go to a party with me at her house?
What kind of party?
I can't say.
I don't think I went.
It was one of those.
No, I think you were trying to get me to go. I don't do that. I don't do that.
You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah. So, hey, I'm going to be covering with Kim Carey, my friend who does Reaching Out. She's a host of Reaching Out, which is my nonprofit show. It's $75 for a 15-minute nonprofit show. But I'm a member of the Troy Chamber of Commerce, and they have a nonprofit network. And I've been going to these meetings every month, and they all, like, help each other and give each other recommendations and ideas and stuff. Well, they're having a nonprofit network conference on Wednesday, April 29th from 8 a.m. to 3. It's at Woodside Bible Church. And they're going to talk about, you know, marketing, donor relations, and strategic planning. And I'm going to be there with a camera, and Kim's going to be interviewing all these people. So it's going to be a lot of fun, and I think it's going to be a lot of good information if you have if you're part of a nonprofit or you know somebody that is. So I'm really looking forward to that. That's a good group of people. It's going to be fun.
Speaking of something to do, what's going on tonight?
Oh, yeah, Maggie, our floor manager. We don't have a camera on her, but she's right over there. Maggie, tell us where you're going to be tonight.
I will be performing at How's By You Cajun Restaurant in Ferndale, which is on Woodward, just north of 9 Mile, for Fat Tuesday. They're having a big party. We start at 4:30. I will have a banjo player with me.
Ooh.
We'll play for about 3 hours, and then we've got another musician, John Latini, will come in. So there'll be free music all night.
Get your gumbo giveaways. On, baby.
I love House by You, and Maggie is super fun. She's really good. I can't even imagine. The banjo player is probably super awesome.
Oh, yeah.
So that's tonight. If you're watching us live at home.
Yes. Free king cake. You get free king cake, and if you get the piece of cake with the baby in it.
Yeah. Then you're going to have
a
baby.
No.
What if you choke on the baby?
I know.
How big is this baby?
How come I never hear of choking?
I choked once on a hot dog at a school function, and I couldn't breathe. My family's going to say,
there will
be
no choking.
I know. But have you ever choked before? Like bad? It's the scariest thing you can imagine. And
it is scary.
You need to know the Heimlich. I gave myself the
Heimlich
maneuver.
Death and dying. That's what we're death and dying. We're now on the topic.
I know we go from a party to almost dying. But I gave myself the Heimlich maneuver.
You're going to have to demonstrate that for us one day.
How
you give yourself the Heimlich remover. What's it called? Heimlich
maneuver.
Maneuver.
Maneuver, not remover. Get that Heimlich out of here. Remove him.
You need permission to remove my Heimlich.
How do you spell Heimlich?
I don't even know if I'm pronouncing it right.
Heimlich.
Oh, wait. We got a letter to read. Quick. Whoa, no. We didn't get to read the letter from our super special boss who gives us hot tips every day. But we'll open that next time. So thank you for watching the Chatty Patty.
Paula Walla.
Talk Show.
Hello.
We will talk about the things that mean so much to you, like going to a restaurant or hanging at the zoo, clothes and sports and funny news, crafts and travel too. Nothing ever scripted, so expect the unexpected.
Hello. It's the Chatty Patty Paula Walla Talk Show.